Thank you, Mr. President. Mr. President, ladies and gentlemen, Senate, I do appreciate my colleague from Oxford going a little bit further. Appreciate the fact that we do have tobacco products, a prohibition on tobacco products, liquor, imitation liquor, gaming activities, lotteries, and bail. The problem lies in the next section of the amendment. 11B. And that is where the first offense comes in. When one is going through the TANF orientation, there's a form that gets filled out. And it's for TANF or PAS, which is parents as scholars, and there's also this form is also used for main care applications. Two pages, and both of them are printed on both sides of the yellow copy and a white copy. On the back of the, which would be the last page, having to do with sections. I'll read it. When an individual on purpose breaks the rules listed below, which I'll go on to the rules since that's in question right now, breaks the rules listed below. The rules. And this is a bold and it's bordered and it's brought about, you know, call attention to it. The rules. Do not lie or hide anything or get or continue to get benefits. Do not trade or sell your FSP, which is food supplement program, food stamps. Do not use someone else's food stamps. Do not use food stamps to benefit or do not use food stamps benefits to buy ineligible items such as alcohol, drugs, and tobacco. Okay, go back to the first line. When an individual on purpose breaks the rules listed below, they will be disqualified from TANF, parents of scholars, and food supplement programs. This way. First, 1 year for the first offense, 2 years for the second offense, and permanently for the third offense. 2 years for the first offense and permanently for the second offense for trading your benefits for drugs. 2 years for drugs. Forever for conviction of trafficking your benefits of $500 or more. Forever for the first offense of trading your benefits for firearms, ammunition, and explosives. And 10 years for finding a fraudulent representation of your identity to receive additional benefits. So I'm going to be throwing in a different level of enforcement by this. So we'll have two different levels of offenses within the program. Secondly, the bill in Section 5, or the amendment in Section 5, has the Department of Health and Human Services shall develop an educational program for recipients of benefits under TANF, and telling recipients as to what they can and cannot do. And I have in my hand, what is TANF, Temporary and Community Families? It's provided by the Office of Family Independence. It is something that anybody that's applying for TANF goes through the TANF orientation, which I did last fall. Sat through an orientation plus an application process. And in that, on page 6, TANF should be used to pay a reasonable amount of basic living expenses. This is part of their education. Basic living expenses like shelter, utilities, transportation, clothing, personal hygiene, household maintenance, employment, or school-related items, or other necessary essential items. Continuing the education. State law prohibits the use of your EBT card in any cash transaction in a retail store over 50% more. This is the liquor, the gaming, and the adult entertainment. Last page. EBT card or cash assistance benefits shall not be used to purchase lottery tickets, gambling, alcohol, cigarettes, tobacco. Shall not. Different from state prohibiting. At any rate, when you go through the process. You go through the orientation. The department goes through this with you. They also, at that time of application and through the orientation process, line up with a family contract. And family contract, in that process, you get educated as to where your benefits are or are not to be used. And that is signed. You're acknowledging the fact that you've gone through that. And on an annual basis, you are educated every year. You get the education portion again. So, do I think the department has an education program already established? Yes, I do. Section 5, unnecessary. Already doing it. That seems to be a theme of what I say today. Also, Section 6 of the amendment. Collect information on the cost and impact of implementing and enforcing the prohibition set forth. Almost seems like closing the barn door after the proceeds hours. So I appreciate my colleague from Oxford putting in the prohibitions, but I just simply cannot support an amendment like this where I've got a second degree of enforcement penalties and sanctions.